Hi, my name's Duncan. I'm fishing here at Oakview. I just wanted to give you a quick demonstration of what are the tactics and the setup I'm using. To start with, I'm using a running rig setup with a light lead and a combi link. Fairly unusual, but it does really work. So the important thing with this is to have a fluorocarbon line. It's heavy, sinks right to the bottom, and also it's less stretch in it than ordinary mono, so it becomes much more sensitive. With the running rig itself, you've got a very light lead, you don't need heavy leads, no leader either. To me, that's a good aspect of fish safety, where if you've got a leader, it changes the weak point from the swivel to the top of the leader. So if you get a snap off, if you lose a fish, that's going to snap there, and the leader itself will still be attached to the fish, and there's less chance of the lead being ejected. So light running lead, it's a smallish lake, so I don't need to cast far. On top of that, then we've got a little buffer bead just to stop the lead from hitting the swivel. On top of that, we've got a helicopter sleeve, and that's onto a quick link swivel, so I can swap and change the hooks very quickly, and I can have some ready made up. The hook link itself is just a combi link, and I've got 12 pound fluorocarbon on there, and it's attached to a very short piece of 22 pound braid, and that creates a very nice a flexible link, and it secures a good hook hold. Also got a blowback style here, and for this particular instance I'm using sweet corn. Okay, so just going to cast out now and show you how I actually set the line up. So a little flick out on this occasion, feather it down, and you'll notice with this fluorocarbon line how it sinks. Already it's sinking. Let it lie all the way along, flat along the bottom. So okay, it's gone off completely slack now. Just play off a little bit more. Attach this. This is just a guide. It's not really an indicator as such. It's just a guide for the line to make sure that sensitivity and goes through the roller. So I've got nice and slack, and I'll just tighten up a little bit because this helps to add to the bolt effect. So when the fish does actually take, you can see there, it's a bit harder to take off. And finally, just to set it, just put the line in the clip, and again, when the fish takes off, that'll hit the clip, and that'll increase the bolt effect.
Classic hook hold, 1 inch inside the bottom lip.
Thirty to 11. 17 fish of the week. Yeah, move on. Right, now that looks pretty good. Good fish. The three great advantages of the system are, firstly, no back leads. You don't get liners because the line is tucked away, and fish can swim over your lines without bumping into them, so they don't spook off. And finally, of course, you can, when you're playing fish, it's a lot easier because again, they won't bump into your line, they won't pick up your lines, generally speaking. So you can play even with a three rod setup, you can play the fish right over your rods. This ain't gonna give up. This has the makings of a very good fish. unless it's a bionic common. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, nice.